Hi, I'm Rachael, and I worked with Mike McNeill on the example app for his JavaScript course, Ration. So neither Mike nor I are visual designers in any way, but since we're on a small team, we often end up having to play kind of that role, especially when working with startups on like prototypes and MVPs. So since Ration kind of fits into that category, we kind of decided to do the design ourselves, and even if it's not the most beautiful app, at least it looks kind of deliberate. So I want to talk a little about the process that we used as non-designers to make a more deliberate-looking app. The first thing we did was we just sat in front of a whiteboard and we just drew the ugliest possible screens, just laying out all of the features that we would need for the app. And after that, we went on to making the real wireframes. And I used Adobe XD for that. A lot of times Mike likes to use Keynote. You can really use whatever you want, just as long as you have something you can look at as you're building the app. It just, even if it's not the most beautiful thing, it helps so much to know exactly what you're building beforehand. And so we decided to use Bootstrap 4 for just kind of the meat of the CSS. And so one of the important things I've learned when working with Bootstrap is that you can't just throw it on a page and expect it to look better. It usually doesn't. You really have to read the docs and familiarize yourself with the different components. And when you do that, you can, even if you're not a designer, you can kind of recreate that in Keynote or XD or Sketch or whatever you're comfortable using. And you can make it look pretty nice. And another thing that that's pretty important for like when you're working with Bootstrap, but you want it to look like an app that has had some kind of design. One of the tricks we use a lot is coming up with like a nice color palette that's not just the default colors in Bootstrap. So I like to use coolers.co. It's like colors, but cool, I guess. And I just go in there and you just start slamming the space bar until you see something that looks like it'll look nice on the page. And I'm a fan of purple, so I like this one. And then you just take those and you can, Bootstrap 4 doesn't have a customizer yet like Bootstrap 3 did, but you can still customize it. We actually, in the example app, in the final code for it, the bootstrap.css file has a link for how we customize our Bootstrap themes. Other than that, I think the other trick that we use a lot is just picking a nice font and just keeping it simple. So I hope next time you start building something new, even if you're not a designer or don't have a designer on board, that you'll really take the time to just like make some basic wireframes and just think about what it is you're building, because it really makes a huge difference at the end of the day. Oh, look, a button. You should click it for more information, because we've worked really hard on this course, and I think you'll learn a lot from it. It's a great way to build an app from start to finish. Also, if you like this, you should subscribe to Platzi's channel for more content like this.